In this video, we're going to look at the process for adding a parts list and balloons to an Autodesk Inventor assembly drawing. Here I already have a view placed of an assembly. My particular view is an isometric view, but it could also be an orthographic view as well. I'll start by creating my parts list. I'll switch to the Annotate tab, then in the Table panel, select Parts List. Then I will select the view that I want to work with. Then I have a couple of choices for the type of view that I want. So this goes back to the concept of the bill of material, and if we want a structured or parts only view. A structured view is going to show subassemblies. Parts only, just like it says, is going to only lay out each individual part. This particular assembly doesn't have any subassemblies, so it really doesn't matter which one I choose. I'll go ahead and click OK, then click to place my table. A lot of the information in the table is coming from the properties for each individual part. So if I want to adjust this information, I can do so in each individual part file. I can control what is being displayed here by selecting the table, right-clicking and going to Edit Parts List. Here I have my Column Chooser button, where I can decide what other fields I might want to display in this particular drawing. I'll go ahead and click OK to accept the defaults though. As you can see, each component has been given a number, and I now want to balloon the parts so that I can see which is which. Once again, here on the Annotate tab, in the Table panel, I'll select the Balloon tool. Then I will simply select a part I want to add a balloon to, and then click to place it. I can decide if I want to actually draw a horizontal leader, or I can just right-click and continue. Once more, I can continue clicking additional parts to place balloons. So as you can see, after creating the view of the assembly, very easy to create a parts list and the balloons associated with that parts list.